The peak of the fighting in Bangui lasted only for a couple of days. In terms of humanitarian consequences, this is among the worst I've seen in the 11 years I work for ICRC. We have to remember that the people here did not have much to begin with. We're talking of one of the poorest countries in the world. If you add conflict, looting, and displacement to the long-existing poverty and underdevelopment, you end up with a population in despair. Some of these people are now in their fifth month of displacement, which means that for the past 5 months, they have been drinking water of very questionable quality, they have been eating whatever they can find, they've probably not seen a doctor or a nurse, and their children have not been to school. In Bangui, hospitals are now almost back to their capacity before the 24th of March, so we can say that the most urgent medical needs in Bangui are taken care of. I'm afraid, though, that we cannot say the same about the rural areas. Many people who have fled in the bush have practically no access to healthcare, and this for several months now, as many health centers have been looted and their personnel has fled to Bangui or to other places. I would say that the most urgent need is to improve security throughout the country. Humanitarian organizations have been playing a very important role because the state is often unable to provide services to a large part of the population. These very same humanitarian organizations, which have helped the local population for many years, cannot work because of the insecurity. Unfortunately, the international community does not seem to have the Central African Republic very high on its agenda. But I feel that more should be done for this country in terms of making more funds available for humanitarian organizations. Humanitarian programs in the area of health, water supply, food security, for example, are of a life-saving nature, and no effort should be spared to secure funding, at least for this kind of operations.